Welcome to another episode of VEGA Talk Radar versus Ultrasonic. Today, we're talking about blocking distance and what happens when sensors flood. Jürgen, you'll certainly help us here again.
Gladly.
There are many containers that hold aggressive media, such as acids or alkalis. For example, this chemical container behind me, filled with iron chloride, reliable measurement, right up to the antenna, is important here.
The problem with ultrasonics is, the sound transducer is a loudspeaker and microphone in one. While transmitting signals, it cannot receive any signals. This creates a blocking distance. Ultrasonic is not necessarily suitable for applications where there's a high chance of overflowing. We do not have this problem with radar sensors. A radar sensor can simultaneously emit and receive signals. This means there is no blocking distance. You can measure levels that reach right up to the sensor itself.
What does the blocking distance mean for the measuring point?
We have a water tank here, and now I'm getting closer and closer to the water surface with the sensor. As you can see, when I reach the blocking distance of about 25 centimeters, the sensor displays an error message. This means it cannot detect the level in this close range correctly. The worst-case scenario could even be an overfilling of the container because of this. A radar sensor measures the received signal even while it is transmitting. Because of this, the sensor can measure levels very close to the antenna. Even if the sensor is submerged, it still displays the limit level. This means measurement with a radar sensor is much more reliable compared to an ultrasonic device.
I've heard that radar can also measure right through plastics. Is this true?
Yes. Note that I'm using the same material here that this container is made of. The microwave radar signals pass right through this plastic sheet, allowing the sensor to measure the water surface with no direct physical contact to the medium. This is, of course, ideal for aggressive media, because you don't have to worry if the sensor has high chemical resistance or not.
Thank you, Jürgen. And thank you for tuning in. If you want to learn how this relates to buildup and deposits, just watch the next video in the series, Radar versus Ultrasonic.